Hi guys, last Sunday I shared with you about God's blessed assurance, the protection, peace, comfort, and joy we have in the blessing of God's Holy Spirit. In light of much that is happening right now in the world, I want to share from my study a thought from A.C. Dixon. He writes, "When we depend upon organizations, we get what organizations can do. When we depend upon education, we get what education can do. When we depend upon man, we get what man can do. But when we depend upon God, we get what God can do. Because there are no limits to his power, we believe that God can do anything." In Luke 18, Jesus says, "The things which are impossible with men are possible with God." Listen to this little boy recount God doing something impossible with the Israelites. On the way home from church one Sunday, a father asked his little boy what he had learned in Sunday school that morning. The son said, "We learned about the children of Israel crossing the Red Sea." The father smiled and asked the boy to tell him about it. "Well," his son said, "the Israelites left Egypt, but Pharaoh and his army chased after them. So the Jews ran as fast as they could until they got to the Red Sea. The Egyptian army was getting closer and closer. So Moses sent the Israeli Air Force to bomb the Egyptians. And while that was happening, the sea bees built a bridge across the Red Sea. When all the Jews were safely across, Moses told the Air Force to let the Egyptians through. And then Moses sent the Israeli Navy SEALs to wire the explosives to the bridge. As the Egyptians were crossing the bridge, Moses detonated the explosives and blew the Egyptian army to smithereens." By now, the father was shocked. He looked at his son and asked, "Is that the way your Sunday school teacher taught you the story?" The boy responded, "Well, no, not exactly. But if I told you what they told me, you'd never believe it." And that little boy was right. The Lord did something unbelievable. 2 weeks ago at prayer time, Steve Frick shared with us this fantastic Habakkuk verse that really brought peace to my mind about why God does not always share all the details of his plans with us. Like us, Habakkuk was complaining about all the problems going on around him, asking God why he lets all that destruction and evil take place. God answers Habakkuk saying, "Look at the nations and watch. Be utterly amazed, for I am going to do something in your days that you would not believe even if you were told." What I get from this is, pay attention. Look out there and watch. Is God about to do his unbelievable among us? Is he telling us, like he told Habakkuk, "Keep your eyes open because I'm about to do something you wouldn't believe, even if somebody told you." Psalm 135:6 says, "The Lord does whatever pleases him in the heavens and on the earth and in the seas and all their depths." Because God created all things and is in control of all things, then he has the right to do whatever pleases him without consulting anyone. I love this little statement from Dr. S. M. Lockridge about creation. Lockridge writes, "The reason God came from nowhere is because there wasn't anywhere for him to come from. And coming from nowhere, he stood on nothing, for there was nowhere for him to stand. And standing on nothing, he reached out where there was nowhere to reach and caught something where there was nothing to catch. Then he hung that something on nothing and told it to stay there, and nobody said a word because there wasn't anybody around to say anything. And then God said to himself, 'This is good.'" It was all good. God created a good thing. Everything God makes is good. It is we who came in and messed things up. And yes, we are still quite messed up, messing it up right now as much as ever. We need to remember that God is in control. He made something from nothing, and we should rest easier knowing he has the same ability to make something from something else. He makes something from tragedy. He makes something from grief. He makes something from loneliness, sadness, and sin. He pulls the sinners up out of the dark and makes something beautiful shine from their lives. Jesus is the greatest light in the midst of this grimy mess. And as long as we cling to him, to his promise and to his goodness, we'll be all right. Let's pray. Our Father, we thank you. Thank you for revealing yourself as the one who created all, sustaining all, and loving all and everything. Help us to love you in return. Help us to love each other like you love us. Help us to rest easy knowing that you're in control. Help us to thank you that you would provide, that you would sustain, and that you would help us to flourish because of your great love. And help us always to give you the praise. In the Master's name we pray. Amen.